Hi, my name is Mayur and the project is density and priority based traffic signal control system. So if you see the problem, so one of the major problems community face every day is mismatched traffic signal. So what is mismatched traffic signal? So the length of the signal does not correspond to the number of vehicles on the road, and this causes various issues. So let us take an example. In the current system, if there is no vehicle on a particular side of the road, even then signal still functions on a fixed time delay, turning green and turning red. Despite there being vehicles at other signals, this causes frustration to the driver, leading to serious problems such as road rage and causes people to jump the signal. So even though there are no vehicles on one side of the road and there are a lot of vehicles on the other side of the road, signal still works equally for both the sides and still changes or swaps its position from red to green and green to red for same time period. But we have to make it according to, we have to make the time period of the green or red signal according to the density of the vehicles which are waiting for crossing that signal. So in order to solve this problem, I'm gonna build traffic density monitoring system that smartly changes the signal based on the vehicular density on each lane. So for this project, we require these components. So Arduino microcontroller, infrared proximity sensors, RFID reader module, RFID tag, and RGB LEDs, red, green, blue LEDs. So what is the Arduino microcontroller? So Arduino is an open source, a computer hardware and a software company, project and user community that designs and manufactures microcontroller kits for building digital devices and interactive objects that can sense and control objects in the physical world. The project's products are distributed as open source hardware and software which are licensed under GNU Lesser General Public License or the GNU General Public License. So microcontroller is open source. Next one is the infrared proximity sensor. So infrared proximity sensor consists of IR emitter and IR receiver. So these two are embedded on a single chip. It measures the distance by sharing a beam of infrared light and causes a photo transistor and uses a photo transistors to measure the intensity of the light that bounces back. If an object is closer than the shortest distance, it reports significantly higher analog output and is inconsistent with expected in-range result. So if an object is closer to it, it gives significantly higher analog output, and if it's too far, it gives less higher analog output. So according to that, we can decide the length or the distance of that object also. The effective distance measuring range for this proximity sensor is 10 to 80 cm. RFID reader module. So RFID is radio frequency identification. So RFID reader module. So the RFID reader is used to read RFID tags, which contains certain unique data stored in the chip. An RFID reader and RFID tag both have a coil surrounding them. When the RFID tag is shown near to the RFID reader, it collects the unique ID or the tag data, a combination of digits and characters from RFID tag into RFID reader. Both RFID reader and RFID tag comes with a coil in them. We power the RFID reader from a power supply for reading purpose. When we power the RFID reader, the coil gets excited and it creates electromagnetic induction. And due to this electromagnetic induction between two coils, this power of the chip inside the RFID tag, and the chip or the RFID tag sends the data to the RFID reader, and the RFID reader successfully notes down this data serially. Now this is the RFID reader module interface. So RFID reader and Arduino UNO. So RFID reader, Arduino it's connected with the ground pin, and the TX pin is connected with RX pin of Arduino. So this is the interface. 12 volts are required for RFID reader and 5 volts are required for Arduino. So the RFID reader module is biased to plus 12 volts using an external source, or to a 5 volt using the Arduino supply. The output of a reader is connected to RX port of the Arduino board, and TX is connected to RX. That's all. The output of RFID is taken as input on into RX 9th pin. So the block diagram for this one is, so RFID tag we are reading using RFID signal, or detecting RFID signal, that we are going to Arduino microcontroller. Also we are taking the IR transmitter output into IR receiver, and that one we are feeding to Arduino microcontroller. So we are feeding two things. So one is RFID signal and one is IR signal, which is coming from IR receiver, and we are getting RGB LED. So according to the RFID tag signal, which is detected by RFID reader and IR receiver, we are pushing these two signals together so that microcontroller can process on that. That microcontroller is Arduino, can process on it, and it can glow RGB lights or that traffic control signals according to it. So how do we implement? The IR proximity sensors are placed at regular intervals on the sides of a lens. So we are placing IR proximity sensors at regular intervals on the sides of the lens or roads. We can decide the length of tangent traffic on a road based on these sensors. Based on the idea, the traffic signal at the lane is prioritized. If the traffic density is the same through all roads, the algorithm returns to the conventional scheduling cycle, else we can change on it. Okay, so we are placing IR proximity sensors at equal intervals on both sides of the lanes, and then we are deciding the. So we are placing the IR proximity sensors on the regular intervals on the both sides of the road, and we are deciding the strength of the tracking based on it. Based on this idea, we are controlling the traffic signal, we are prioritizing it. So, addition to the project. In addition to the dynamic traffic signal scheduling, the system also detects an ambulance approach by reading the RFID mounted on it. The RFID reader module is placed on every road, which when detects an ambulance prioritizes the road signal first. After the ambulance passes the signal, the system remotes to the conventional scheduling. See, in the normal project we are placing the IR sensors on regular intervals, and basis of this we are checking the density of the vehicles, and according to that we are prioritizing our traffic signal so that less interruption should be there for the traffic or the people who want to cross the signal, and less staggeration of the traffic happen. And adding to it, we are placing a RFID reader and a RFID chip on the ambulance. When the RFID reader reads the RFID chip, it detects that there is an ambulance coming or ambulance standing in the traffic. So there is no need of the straight line alignment for reading an RFID chip for an RFID reader. So when an RFID chip just comes in proximity or in surrounding of RFID reader, it detects that and it automatically changes the signal, traffic signal order, so that we can pass ambulance as soon as possible, and we'll arrange the all traffic signals on that road according to which the ambulance can pass very easily. So first one we are doing the IR reader one, and then we are doing the ambulance one using RFID reader or RFID module. The application of this project, this can be used in heavy vehicular traffic in metropolitan cities, and to avoid the stagnation of the traffic at the same place for more time, and having the active, more dynamic traffic signal control system, and providing an ease for the ambulance too. The importance. So this is a robust system, may replace the conventional traffic management system, thus it can eliminate the errors. This implementation of the system reduces the road accident rates to a very great threshold. So generally road accident occurs when the people jumps the signal, and they jump because there are no people on the road, or there is no one in the road due to the conventional traffic, due to the conventional traffic control signal system. So we are making it active traffic control system according to the density of the traffic. So there will be no need of anyone to jump the signal. So there are less chances of this road accident rates. Also, we are providing an easy path for ambulance. So there are less chances by ambulance to have an accident. So that's all about my project. Thank you.